Histograms are a great visual representation of relative frequencies or probabilities of events. We're going to take a look at a finite sample space for the experimentation of rolling two die. So I'm going to roll two die and record the sum on those die. Now, all the possible outcomes of rolling two die are listed in this tabular form. We can see that when we roll a 1 and a 1, that we get a sum of 2, and that's the only way to get a sum of 2. Over in the table to the right, we have the sum of die in the first column, and x is the outcome. The outcome of rolling a sum of 2 has a probability of 1 out of 36. It's 1 out of 36 because there are 36 different ways to roll 2 die. Now, if I wanted to look at the sum of rolling 3, that would be a 2 and a 1 or a 1 and a 2. That means that there are 2 out of 36 ways to roll a 3. If we continue to look along the diagonals, we will find the sum of a 1 plus 3, which is 4, and that's continuing to be the same sum along the diagonal. So the chance of rolling a sum of 4 is 3. Then the chance of rolling a sum of 5 is 4. The event of rolling a sum of 7 has the highest probability, 6 out of 36. You'll notice in this table that the probabilities increase, and then once we hit the sum of 7, they begin to decrease. The histogram to the right is a pictorial way of representing those probabilities. We can in fact see that there's symmetry going on with the probabilities or relative frequencies. This picture is called symmetric. Both the left and the right hand side are symmetric to one another. A histogram can help us to visually find out probabilities in a more rapid rate. If I wanted to know the probability of an event having a sum greater than 9, I would add the probability of 10, 11, and 12 together. Those relative frequencies were 336, 236, and 136, which add to 636 and reduces to 1/6. When you develop a histogram, one important piece to remember is that this is a finite sample space. All of the outcomes should be listed on the bottom. The bars lie right above and centered above the numbers. There'll be no spaces in between the bars unless a particular outcome has a probability of 0. Another feature of a histogram in relationship to relative frequencies and probabilities is that the area of all of these bars sums up to 1, because we know the sum of all of our events is 1.